Hi, in this video I'm going to take you through the solar and Tesla Powerwall 2 stats for April 2019. But before that, we need a coffee. To walk you through the stats for our solar and Tesla Powerwall 2 setup for April 2019. If this is your first time here and you want to learn more about our solar installation or photography, cinematography, working with models, that kind of thing, then start today by subscribing and hit the notification bell icon to be notified of new updates as and when I upload them. So, as I said in the intro, we're going to be looking at the stats for our solar and Tesla Powerwall 2 for April 2019. And just to set the scene for you, so you know what you're comparing, sort of apples with apples, as it were. We live in the UK, in the East Midlands. We have a 4K array, solar array, with Sony panels on it. And that's connected to a Sunnyboy 3.8 kilowatt inverter, and we have a Tesla Powerwall 2, which was installed in December of 2018 to our existing solar panels. I've had the panels since 2011, so we've got quite a lot of data on those. And because of the age of the installation, in terms of the solar installation, the Sunnyboy inverter doesn't give you a web interface, so I can't pull up a web interface to show you the solar. So what I have been doing since 2011 is recording day by day the stats and dropping them into a spreadsheet, and that's what I'm going to bring up to show you the April stats, as well as combining that with the data from the Tesla app on the phone. April was awesome, really, in terms of a month for us. So let's just bring those stats up on screen. I've got my spreadsheet open. I'm not going to go through a day by day for you, but I will bring up the detail on screen. So if you're interested in looking at in more detail, you can pause the video and have a mooch through the figures at your leisure. In terms of the spreadsheet that I keep, I will make a link to that available because a few people have asked about that. I'll drop it in a Dropbox and put a link to it in the description down below. So if that's of interest to you, by all means, feel free to use, adapt, etc. Share. The first tab I have is my PV reads. So at the end of each solar day, I record how many kilowatt hours we've produced, and do a rolling average since 2011, which, if you're interested, is 11.4 kilowatts per day, a rolling average. Next tab is the the Powerwall 2, and that has quite a lot of data on it. It has the percentage contribution to self power for solar and for the Powerwall, and a total self power percentage, which is taken from the Tesla app. And then record the home usage in kilowatt hours, the solar kilowatts generated, what we've taken from the Powerwall, what we've driven to the Powerwall, what we've taken from the grid, and what we've given to the grid. I didn't say in the intro that our setup is purely solar driven. But we don't take any additional power, as it were. So we're not on a low tariff at the moment, and there's a couple of reasons for that, which I'm not going to go into in this particular video because they're a little bit long-winded. But all of the figures and all the stats we're talking about here is purely powered from solar. So we don't add any charge to the Powerwall from a low tariff feed or anything like that at the moment. We'll do in the future, but more of that later in another video. I also started recording towards the end of March, the start of the solar day, in terms of when we started producing power from the solar panels, and the end of the solar day as well. So I was starting to see how that panned out over the seasons and the course of the year. So that's this spreadsheet here that you're looking at. If I take you to the charts, which sort of encapsulate that information, are perhaps a little bit easier to absorb. This first chart shows you our average daily solar generation and also our total solar generation, again in kilowatt hours, so daily and monthly. The top line with the bigger figures is the monthly, probably work that out yourselves, and then below it in the yellow stacked column is the average daily solar generated. Then that's for the month. If we look at April, which is the month we're talking about, it's the last one there in the column, so we averaged 16.1 kilowatt hours and we produced in total 460 kilowatt hours of solar energy. And if you compare that like for like on April 2018, where we had 11.1 kilowatt as a average, as opposed to 16.1, so up there. And also over the course of the month, we smashed the previous generating figures there. We had 332. As total solar generated during the month of April 2018, and we're in at 460 for this month. So a massive improvement in terms of sun, lots more sun, which then has an impact and a benefit into what the Tesla Powerwall manages to do. So as you know, our Powerwall's only been installed since December 2018, so I'm sort of still building up data on that. So this chart below it, scroll down, shows our percentage contribution to self-power from the Powerwall and also from the solar panels. And that's been tracking up over the course of December, January, February, through to April, as you would expect, as we're heading into our summer here in the UK, which will probably consist of one day. That's typical UK summer. And in the month of April, we did a contribution from the solar of 42%. So, put it another way, solar energy contributed to 42% of our total self-power. And the Powerwall did 37%. So it gives us a total of adding those two together of 79%. So over the course of April, we were self-powered for 79% of the time, which I'm really, really pleased with. It's very impressive for early on in the year. And hopefully that figure will start to increase. And if I just nip back to the previous spreadsheet, the Powerwall read, you'll perhaps notice, and I will highlight them just to make them more obvious. There we go. And if I did actually just the month, John, that would be good. There we go. So the month of April, we had 7 days where we were at 100% charge of the Powerwall. There was a few at 97, there was one at 99. So there was a lot of days where we were almost maxed out on the Powerwall and then starting to give electricity back to the grid. And we had quite a few days where we were carried over the Powerwall charge into the following day rather than using it all up during the day. And Let's see, how many of those do we get? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 11. Yeah, 11. 11 days out of the 30 in April. So again, really, really pleased with that. Looking at our monthly average grid usage, which is the next chart, this tracks how much electricity we pull from the grid on average over the month, and then how much we actually use. And that's a chart that's been tracking away from each other over the previous months. So our monthly average is around about the same, of about 20 kilowatts a day. In December it's 25, and it's been dropping as the daylight has been increasing, so we've been using less electricity. So we're last 2 months we're about 19-20 kilowatt hours a day, and our pull from the grid has dropped significantly. So looking at December, we were 22 kilowatt hours from the grid for our total of 25 used. And now in April we pulled 6 kilowatts from the grid on average, and we're using 20. So that's 14 kilowatts there that we're self powering through our solar panels. And yeah, don't forget, it is purely solar. We're not using any other means to charge our Powerwall and top up the battery that way. We will in the future, but not currently. And yeah, that's about it really. That's the key things I wanted to show you. There are other videos, you'll see them pop up in a second at the end, to have a look at more about our installation. And remember to hit that like button, hit the subscribe button, and yeah, I'll see you on the next one. All right, take care. Bye.